Nate, first things first, what does it mean to you to be recognized by the league as the top goalkeeper in the conference this year?
Yeah, I mean, it feels really great, to keep it short and sweet. Since I got here back in 2019, I've always had that goal of becoming keeper of the year and just trying to reach that. And now that I finally have, with the help of the guys, it really means a lot, and I'm honored and grateful for that.
Turning to the task at hand, you guys coming into postseason here, and obviously stakes couldn't be a whole lot higher. You guys were in a similar situation a couple of years ago, and it didn't go your way. What are kind of some of the things that you guys are focusing on to try and make sure that something like that doesn't happen again?
I think one of the biggest things for us is just, especially the returning guys, we all came together and really just came down to the mindset, like, we can't let that happen again. Like, all of us, after that game, it was such like a gut-wrenching result that obviously we didn't want. And as Dallas said before, we felt as a group that we just left something out on the field that day. I think it's just the biggest thing for us is just not letting that happen again and having the mindset of just going out and attacking and keeping our destiny in our own hands. And that's what we're going to look to do on Wednesday.
Speaking of mindset, a lot of time off heading into this game. How have you been keeping yourself sharp and the team too?
So anytime we have a big stretch of games, span of time in between games like that, it's really important to just keep the level high in training and also recovery, make sure guys are getting treatments and everybody's at their top level, because at the stretch, this stretch of the season especially, being healthy is really important, and being at the top of your game is the most important thing that we can do. So I think we're just focused on keeping guys healthy, staying in the right mindset, and just being ready for the task at hand, and which is to win on Wednesday night.
Being that NJIT is coming off a much shorter wait than you guys, how have you tried to handle it mentally, knowing that you're going into a game against a team coming off a big win?
Yeah, so a team like that having 90 minutes of playoff experience already can be beneficial for them. But it's also beneficial for us in the sense that they could be a little bit tired, have some tired legs, with less time off in between. So I guess that's a benefit for us. But at the same time, it's just we have been playing them for, this will be our fourth time in the past year, so we know them very well. And we've scouted them well, and we have a pretty good game plan of using our size against them, because they're a relatively small team. They can possess the ball pretty well, but where we excel is on set pieces and taking advantage of our size. So I think if we execute that well and play well defensively, I think we'll be successful.
The women had a pretty impressive game Sunday, made it, punch their ticket to the tournament. How, the guys were all there. How did that kind of influence your mindset maybe going into your playoff run?
Well, us just being there, at least for me, it was like, it just made me feel like, geez, like that's something that I want to be able to experience, and I think just all the guys being there as a collective unit, we all share that same sense of hunger and drive and want to win, and coming up short the past couple times, it has been really, really tough on the guys. So it's like this year we need to make sure that it's our time, and it starts with Wednesday night.
Do